Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today, Krista and I are going to show you our nighttime skincare routine. So just what we do to get our makeup off, get our skin ready for bed, and all of that after a long day of work or sweat or whatever.
I'm just laying on the couch eating Ben and Jerry's watching Parks and Recreation.
No matter what you do, whether it's work, school, play, you still need to have some sort of You still need to have some sort of nighttime skincare routine, no matter what. As you guys know, the number one thing is to always wash your makeup off before you go to bed. Krista and I both have fresh, clean faces on right now with absolutely nothing. We wanted to show you what we use to wash our faces right now. Personally, I am always alternating between face washes just because I'm always trying new things. I haven't exactly found an exact one that I love yet that I have committed to, so I've just been trying a lot of different face washes. So right now, I've been using the Loreal Pure Clay Cleanser. So this cleanser, it smells really, really good. It says it has three pure clays and charcoals. Krista used this one as well. She already finished hers. It's a detox brighten clay to mousse. So when you do use it, it is pretty like chunky, but once you start rubbing it in, it starts foaming up and it's really easy to scrub with. The reason that this size is so small is because we actually got this in our Target beauty box, which you can get at Target. It was only $7 and there were like three different kinds of boxes. And this is one that came with the box.
Yeah, we didn't think it had, and we both got the same boxes. We were together and we bought the same box. I don't know why we didn't get two different ones.
We both just really liked what came in the box, but we realized that we probably should have both gotten different ones so that we can just like exchange stuff in there and try different things out. So this is the current face wash I've been using. It works really well.
I really like that one.
The smell is really good. It's not like overpowering or anything.
It's just gentle. It smells refreshing.
Yeah, it smells very refreshing. So this is what I've currently been using for face wash.
So mine is kind of like ratchet. It's fine though. I finally found a face wash. It's not even a face bar. I use the Shea Moisture, like black African soap. It is very, I kind of have like combination skin. Like I can't be greasy, I can't be dry. So this one is really gentle on the skin because I use so many different ones and I used to have really dry skin and I finally worked my way up. Hydration is key. And so I've been like trying to slowly like go through all my products, and this one is one I keep going back to, and like it lasts literally forever. Also nice, it's good on the environment because it's not a lot of packaging, so just saying. And I just bought my little soap holder from Walmart. And I really like it a lot. It's really refreshing and it's not harsh on the skin or anything. It's really gentle.
So just so you guys know, Krista and I have, like, I have combination skin, so I can get really dry on my cheek areas, and then I'm always oily in my T-zone. Sometimes I do get a little oily on the sides right here. Krista's skin has usually, it's usually pretty matte. Like, she doesn't really get too oily, but she does at times. Like, there's some people who have completely, like, matte, even almost dry skin and just never get oily, but I do definitely get a lot more oily than she does. Our skincare routines are kind of similar in some of the things that we use, but also very different. We both have a little bit different order and like different things that we use. So we'll just kind of go back and forth about the things that we use and the steps that we do. So we'll go over like all the different things that we use, the different products, how we use them, why we like them, why we don't like them, whatever, and just kind of go through that process.
When I first moved back home in August, Kayla critiqued my skincare routine to a T because she said I was doing it so wrong. I was like, you don't just wash your face and pat it dry. So your girl moved on up. There's levels to this now. And I think I've kind of, when I'm back on my BS, I'd be looking fly with my skin. But you know, it was finals week. Your girl's kind of rough around the edges, but it's all back.
And just so you guys know, this skincare routine like won't work for everyone. I'm sure there are some products that you use with your skincare that you absolutely love and that's great, but we're just giving our recommendations and just so you guys know like what our personal skin routine is and what we have going on at night.
So what is one thing you're trying to focus on with your skincare?
So one of my main focuses for skincare is I do get a lot of like hormonal acne right here. It's like partially hormonal. I don't know why, maybe it's just like the birth control I'm on, let's be honest here.
We're gonna keep it real.
Honestly,
that's why my skin's clear. Let's be real.
Also, it could just be like my diet. Like my diet is not the best and a lot of that is the skin. So usually I usually get all of my acne on my chin. I never ever get it on my cheeks, really anywhere else. So the focus is mainly just acne, like just keeping it at bay, and then also any like oiliness I have.
Yeah, my main focus, because I look dead all the time. I literally look like I have sunken in eyeballs. Because, like, if you can tell, like, my eye bags are so bad.
Yeah, Chris and I both have, like, mine really have bad so dark bad circles. Lately. And it's not, like, that's not even the shadow.
Like, it's so, like, I have really bad sunken in. Like, if you see from this angle, it looked dead. Like, even when I put my NARS Radiant Cream and Concealer on, like, it's full coverage. Like, it is. Like, the concealer, it works really well. Just my eye bags are so bad. And I've tried a lot of things. I should probably just, you know, put some cucumbers on them or something, but it's just they're so bad. And I've tried a lot of things. Consistency is key, and your girl, my sleep schedule is all over.
So now we're gonna get into the steps of our routine and explain what each of us do in our steps and why we like the products that we show you guys. So after I wash my face, I use this Thayer's Witch Hazel Aloe Vera Rose Petal Toner. This is literally my second bottle. So I've been using this Witch Hazel, which is really great because it has witch hazel in it, aloe vera, and it's alcohol free, so it will not dry your skin out. So what I do is after I wash my face, I just put this on a cotton pad, and this little container, I just put my cotton pads in. I got this from a thrift store, so don't mind that. But you can buy this at a lot of different places. I got mine at Whole Foods, which is where we work at. One bottle is like $10.99, which you may be like, that's kind of steep. It goes a long way. Like, this bottle will last me forever. It also does come in, I believe, a lavender scent.
An original, just like a plain one.
Yeah, so like rose petal, lavender, original. This is my second bottle ever, and this is the rose petal one. My first one was also rose petal, and I really do want to try the lavender one next. And what I really like about this is it's very, like, I don't know, it just goes on really nicely.
I don't even know how to explain the feeling.
The smell is very subtle, it's not overpowering, and it honestly just, like, makes my skin feel so soft. Like, it just feels so good after, and I see people buy this all the time at work. So this is a toner I use, and then I just use it on some cotton pads.
So when I, like I said, when I moved back, when she critiqued my skincare routine, she said I started needing to use toner, and I was like, well, what is that? Don't even know what it is. I don't even know what it technically does, but I like the way it feels. So I have the same one, but it's a baby one because I travel, and so it's easier to bring. I just refill it with this. And like Kayla said, how much is one of those at work? Like $10.99. They have like a twin pack of them at work for like
$15.99.
Yeah, which you save like $5 if you really think about it. So what I did, I bought a 2-pack, kept one for myself. Christmas time, I put that one in Kayla's stocking. Like,
it's really great.
Yeah,
present.
It's honestly because they last like a little goes a long way.
Just so you guys know, also everything that we mentioned today, I will put a link to it down below in the description box in case y'all are wondering what it is, how much it is, more information about it. It'll all be down below. And if you guys have any questions, again, please feel free to let us know. So yes, that is the toner that we both use. So once I let the toner dry a little bit, the next thing that I do is I put a serum on. So same thing with, as I was talking about, like my face wash, I don't have a serum that I'm in love with. Right now I've been using this DermaE Purifying Youth Serum. I actually got this at TJ Maxx. It was like $6.99, and I just needed a new one. And so I got this. It's for normal to oily skin, which is great because I'm oily. It says it has marine algae and green tea in it. So I know that you're really not supposed to use your hands when you put things on your face because like your hands are really dirty. So what I do is I just take a little bit of this. It kind of has the consistency of a lotion, but not as thick. I put this on cotton pads, and then again, also just put it all over my face, on my neck, and that's what I do with this serum. And I really like it so far. It's not too bad. It has a really mild smell. I don't really notice a difference of it doing anything for my skin though. I really don't even know what the point of a serum is, but you know, it's cool.
Kayla has one more skin step than me. She has 6, I have 5, and I don't use a serum because no.
After I put my serum on, what I do next is I take this Mario Badescu lavender spray and I spray it all over my face. Now, I have always been a huge fan of the spray. It comes in a rosewater, lavender, and cucumber smell. I've used the rosewater one for a long time. I'm now on the lavender one. It also has aloe and chamomile in it. And it is literally my favorite. I spray it on after my serum. I also will just spray it on throughout the day if I just feel like my face needs to be refreshed.
A little refresher.
Yes. I also, pro tip, I spray it on after I put on my face powder, like just to set my face because it takes the powdery look away.
Also, I put it on my brush before I do highlighter and it make, like it doesn't give the highlight like the highlight like a powdery look. It makes it look like
Really sleek and shiny.
Like dewy.
Yeah, so I spray this on all over my face and it's just so calming. It's also really great for calming redness. And this huge bottle was only like $12. It's like 8 ounces. Yeah. And they come in like a medium and a small one.
After my toner, and this is like a holy grail, kind of, because when I was using it for like weeks consistently, I noticed a difference, but you know, your girl fell off the wagon. So it's by the same brand that makes the goth pads. It's called Rodan Fields. Y'all have probably heard of them because they make an eyelash serum that works wonders. This was about $65, but again, a little goes a long way. I put, just drag it underneath my eyes, I apply it with my ring finger, and then let it chill. Rodan Fields Active Hydration Bright Eye Complex.
So after I apply the Mario Badescu Lavender Spray, and that is dry, because it kind of does take a second to dry depending on how much you put on, but I put a boatload on. I have been using this Ole Henriksen. It is a Sea Rush Brightening Gel Cream, and it is basically, it has 3 ounces of vitamin C and rose of winter extract. It is a moisturizer, and it looks like this. It's orange.
I smell it.
It smells really good. Does kind of smell orangey, and I actually don't know exactly how much this is because I got this for free on Influencer, which if you head over to, I believe it was my first vlog.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, if you head over to my first vlog, if you just click on my channel, it's on there. I talked about Influencer and what it was and how you can get free makeup through it by writing makeup reviews. So that's why I got this one, but I've been using it a lot lately. Again, it smells really good. It has really good ingredients in it. And it doesn't make my skin look greasy, which is a plus because I already am greasy.
This is another holy grail. Again, I don't know anything about skincare, but this is what works for me, and I'm probably doing this all wrong.
The heck?
So this is Renewed Hope in a Jar by Philosophy. It's the biggest one. It's the 4 fluid ounces. It's kind of expensive, and the first time I tried it, I stole it from Kayla and finished the whole entire thing. And so, you know, she tries different stuff all the time. I'm consistent. And so I had to buy it again, and they have like 3 different sizes, but you get 4 fluid ounces for like $60-something. It smells really good, and it's not like super thick cream. Like, you know, cream, like I hate moisturizers that make me feel oily after, and I just feel like it really like absorbs really well, and it feels really nice on my skin. And I just really like it. And so they do have like trial sizes ones and everything like that. So if you're looking for a new one to try, I definitely recommend this one.
So for the last step after I do my moisturizer, the very last thing that I do on my, as far as like my skin goes, it's really the last thing that I do, but I do put a lip serum on my lips. In this thing, you can see I have these little gray pieces in there. So this is the lip serum from Rodan and Fields, which as you guys saw, that is the same brand that makes the gauze pads. That makes the gauze pads and that makes Krista's under eye cream. So this is a lip serum. It looks like lip gloss, like in liquid form, but when you put it on your lips, it is like a deep moisture, which I really needed something like that. My lips are always dry and chapped, and so any kind of like chapstick that I use is just a very temporary solution for my lips, but I started using this lip serum and it's just so good. Like, I put it on overnight, and sometimes I'll even put it on like right before I leave the house, and it'll stay on my lips like all day. So that's like the very last thing that I do in my routine, is use a lip serum all over my lips.
So this is the Mario Badescu, whatever the heck, facial spray with aloe, chamomile, and lavender. I mainly buy these because of the colors, let's be real. So I have the facial cucumber one, like the green one, and that is my ride or die. I love that. It's very refreshing, and I really like that a lot, but I left it in my car and I don't feel like going out there. And so yeah, I just spray this on all over. Kayla definitely uses this a lot more than I do, because we bought these at the same time, and look, her big bottle's like halfway gone. And I have the baby one.
No shame.
Yeah, no shame in her game.
So that was the very last step of our skin routines, nighttime skincare routines. Again, even though in the morning, if you guys are very new to a nighttime skincare routine, it is important that you stick with it to stay consistent, because a lot of times, like, you won't even know your products are working, or you give them a chance to work, unless you use them, I believe, like at least a month straight and consistently. And even though in the morning it is good to wash your face before you start your day and like before you put your makeup on, you may be like, what's the point of even using all this stuff? It is good to just do it. Like, it's just good to have that routine in place to do things at night once you take all your makeup off. And even if I don't wear any makeup, I'll still do this, because yeah, skincare is still super important. So this is our nighttime skincare routine. I hope the products that we talked about helped you guys in some way. If you are on the lookout for any of these kind of products, we hope our recommendations help
and like and make you interested or something in them.
Yeah, like if you've never tried a toner before, maybe you'll try this one, or whatever products that we use. So thank you so much for watching our nighttime skincare routines, and please subscribe and like if you aren't already. Subscribe button is down below.
Like the button if you want to see more of me.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, who's the real party here?
Down in the description box, I will have all of the links of everything that Krista and I both use for our skin routines, in case you do want to click on the links and just get to know the products more, or if you want to order it for yourself. If you guys want to leave me comments down below or any questions that you have about our routines, please feel free to do so down below. We would love answering them, and we'll see you guys in the next video.
Bye.